In this video, you'll learn about the basics of customizing the ASP.NET MVC TreeList extension, starting from adding the extension into the project and binding it to data to diving deeper into an overview of its settings. I have an MVC project here with a home controller and an empty index view. Let's run this and see what it looks like in the browser. All right, here you can see that the content area is empty, so let's return to Visual Studio. The TreeList extension can function in either bound or unbound mode. Since the TreeList is designed to display information in a tree structure, its data source needs two additional fields to build a tree structure. The first is a key field that must contain unique values, and the second is a parent field that must contain values that indicate parent nodes for the current node. Let's take a look at the structure of the threads table. The ID column contains key fields. The parent ID contains the values that indicate parent nodes for the current node. That's exactly what we need. The other columns can contain various types of data. Next, let's create a data model. I return to the Solution Explorer and add the ADO.NET Entity Data Model to the Models folder. I follow the wizard steps and the entity framework generates a data model for me. I save the model, build the solution, and close the model designer. In the view file, I right-click on the required position, and in the context menu, I select the Insert DevExpress MVC extension item. The Insert Extension wizard appears. In the Data tab, I select the tree list. I leave the default extension name and its partial view name. In the Data Model section, I define that the tree list should function in bound mode, select the model type, model context, the columns I want to display, key field, and the parent key. Then I can enable editing, inserting, or deleting, and click the Insert button. The Insert Extension wizard generates all the necessary code for me, and you can see that the view code has been changed. In the output window, I can see what files have been changed or created. Here you can see that the result in the browser is a stunning tree list. It allows you to create, edit, and delete nodes. I can also expand several nodes. Pay attention to the ID and parent ID columns. For example, the fourth node is a child of the third node, and the third node is a child of the first node. Now let's return to Visual Studio and see what the wizard generated for me. In the output window, I select the output from the DevExpress extension integrator. Here I see the view code has been modified by the wizard. It has inserted a link to the partial view. I can double-click the output item and navigate to the changed code, and you can see that the actions have been added to the controller class. Here you can see that the wizard has already added the code that handles the create, update, and delete operations via the entity framework. Let's take a look at the partial view code and the controller code at the same time, side by side. The callback root values are handled by the tree list partial action. The callback root values for the create, update, and delete operations are handled by the corresponding actions. Note that the wizard inserted all this code automatically, so I don't need to type this code manually. And if an error in the create, update, or delete action occurs, then the error text will be passed to the view using the view data dictionary. Now let's look at the settings for the tree list the wizard generated. Here are the settings for the command column. These settings allow you to define the visibility of the Add, Edit, and Delete buttons. The Key Field Name and the Parent Field Name properties allow you to define the names of key and parent fields. This is the code that populates the collection of columns. Here are the settings that enable the pager and allow node selection. The TreeList provides you several settings for items like the TreeList behavior, display, cookies, editing, exporting, pop-ups, and more. Let's hide the ID and parent ID columns by deleting the corresponding code. Okay, we have the column that displays date time values, and we can choose the appropriate editor to edit this column's values. To do this, we should specify the column type. IntelliSense shows me a list of possible column types, and I'll select the date edit type. There are two columns that show Boolean values. The checkbox is the best choice for displaying and editing Boolean values. Next, let's show a summary item within the TreeList. I can add a new summary by specifying its type and the name of the column within which the summary should be calculated. Again, IntelliSense displays a list of possible summary item types. I want to show the count of the nodes under the subject field. Summaries can be shown in the footer of the TreeList, so let's enable footer rendering. Plus, I can enable sorting for the column values. Let's take a look at the result in the browser. Here you can see the amount of nodes under the subject column. Boolean values are displayed conveniently as checkboxes as we see in the last two columns. I can click the column header, and the nodes will be sorted in ascending or descending order. I can add a new node. Here you see that I can edit date time values with the date editor, and the Boolean values can be edited with the checkboxes. I click the Update button, and the new node is saved within the database. Note that the summary item has automatically updated its value. Another great feature is that I can reorder the columns by dragging and dropping them at the required position. And I can select the required nodes. Let's return to Visual Studio and define the pager displaying mode, then define its position and the page size. I don't want to expand the nodes manually, so I enable their automatic expanding. Now you can see that the pager appears and all the nodes are expanded. I can use the pager to navigate between them. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.